and welcome. Today I'm not in my kitchen, but today I'm going to share about how to plan your Antarctica trip. When I posted my Antarctica experience on YouTube video, about 43 minutes of video, which you can actually watch on a big screen, and it's amazing watching those wildlife, nature, and almost everything about Antarctica and also South Georgia and Falkland Islands. And when I posted that video, many of you wanted to know how did we plan our Antarctica trip. Actually, my husband and his friends, they've been planning this for almost last two years actually. I will be sharing all the information I can in this video, but do check out the link provided under this video to get more details, links and everything, all the other tips that you can learn. So I highly recommend to visit the link provided under this video description for my blog. And we do recommend to plan this trip at least 18 to 20 months ahead of time, so that way you can pay your trip cost in installments. In my earlier video, you must have seen we chose Hurtigruten for our Antarctica cruising, and believe me or not, it was the best decision that we ever made by choosing Hurtigruten, because all our needs were taken care of really well, and being vegetarian, we almost got great food every single day, and chef was very close to us. Actually, the chef was totally assigned for our group for making vegetarian dishes, and it was just totally awesome. And we actually flew from Jacksonville, Florida to Buenos Aires, Argentina, and we later, my husband decided that we also want to do Iguazu Falls while we are there. The trip actually got really lengthy because of all the destinations that we added later, but it was worth it. Most of us have, you know, these are the like lifetime destinations on our bucket list. And so when you plan something, and if you are going from that area anyway, then you don't want to miss that opportunity, because you never know when you will be making your next trip on that side. So that's how we ended up having the trip of 26 days. The cost really depends on where you really want to go. Do you just want to go Antarctica, or would you also want to go Falkland Islands, South Georgia? We highly recommend, if you have to pay more money, but do not miss Falkland Islands and South Georgia, because those are kind of destinations not to miss, and this is actually once in a lifetime opportunity, and you may not go on that side again because it's really expensive, and you don't want to just you know, make all these kind of trips without planning. So we plan, actually our goal was to go Antarctica, but then we found that Falkland Islands and South Georgia are the destinations that you never want to miss, because there's like 500,000 penguin colony at St. Andrews Bay, which is just totally amazing. And we did really enjoy even Antarctica, but the most I really enjoyed was South Georgia. So if you are going that way anyway, you do not want to miss these destinations. I requested my husband to make a you know, the notes and some tips that if we can write down that he used throughout the planning. So here are some very valuable tips to plan and make the trip less stressful mentally as well as financially. So the first thing that he has to say is that book your trip in advance, almost 15 to 18 months. The reason is that you can choose the payment in installment rather than paying all at once in just one shot. And do not use Hurtigruten US or European website. Just that, be sure to check out the link on my website where you can get more detail how you can book using Norwegian site. When you go onto the website hurtigruten.com, you can choose the country and choose Norway instead of the United States. So that's the first tip that we learn. He said this so many times to me that I should not forget to mention this, that do not use Hurtigruten US or European website. Always use the Hurtigruten Norway website. It will save you thousands of dollars. And he actually proved it, which I'm going to share on my blog in detail. But just to give you an example, that when he visited Hurtigruten US website, the cost showed him $9,000, which was our cabin without window, and cabin with window was $14,500. That's in the US, because it's from the US Hurtigruten website. Now Hurtigruten Norway website cost is in the NOK, which is $68,000 for cabin without window. And if you convert NOK to US dollars at current rate, it came out to be $7,900. So total saving of $1,100 per person. So it's actually based on double occupancy. So per person, it's actually, we are looking at $7,900. And also the cost increased in our case because we added Iguazu Falls, and he actually contacted Hurtigruten Norway number directly and requested to book the particular trip in Norwegian krone and not US dollars, explaining that I was not happy with the US customer service. They did send the link for payment along with all the information. So then he paid initial deposit of 12,000 NOK, which is the US amount, it came out to be 1,500. Make sure to use a credit card that does not charge for foreign transaction. We have one credit card that we always use when we travel outside of the United States, and we never get charged for the foreign transactions on that card. And so we finished our installments in 15 months, basically, and just three months before the cruise. He used to take advantage when the NOK would be weaker against US dollars. Thus, by using Hurtigruten Norway instead of US, and by using the function in the currency market, he was able to save $3,000 per person, so $6,000 per couple within 15 months. So you gotta look for other things besides like just making the booking from the direct website. You also want to keep that rate fluctuation in mind. And if you are going from Argentina, just be sure to visit Iguazu Falls. It's not to be missed destination. Again, I'm just telling, because it is totally amazing. And kids are not allowed under 12 years old. So if you have kids, then you have to make an arrangement for them first. We had my in-laws, they took care of our kids while we were away for 26 days. With Iguazu Falls, our total cost was $20,500 for both of us. So basically for a couple, it came out to $20,500 for total 26 days, including Iguazu Falls, Falkland Islands, South Georgia, and Antarctica Peninsula. And on the website, actually on the blog, you can read about the cruise as well, what we did and what we did not. There are some extra packages that you can get once you get on cruise, because they do have some other extra activities to do. We actually chose only a couple of them, like nature cruising and all that. We didn't do camping and all that. It was a bit of expensive for us. So that was the total cost that I mentioned, $20,500 US dollar per couple. And you can reduce the cost in almost half if you do not do Iguazu Falls, Falkland Islands, South Georgia. So basically, if you are just looking for Antarctica Peninsula, then you can just expect to reduce the cost in half, which would be like almost $10,000 per couple. But as I said, it's once in a lifetime. So just you know, if you have to wait for a few years, I recommend to wait for a few years and make this plan ahead of time with proper planning and not to miss those destinations that I mentioned earlier. So I hope you enjoy sound of silence for a few days without cell phones, internet, minimum human activity. And believe me or not, once you get there, you will tell that, oh, that I was totally right about it, that not to miss those destinations. And if you are planning Antarctica trip, best of luck and enjoy. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching and see you soon.